Eternal God, who has brought into unity those who are sundered and has ordained for them an individual bond of love, who didst bless Isaac and Rebekah and didst make them heirs of thy promise, bless also these your servants, Alexander and Stephanie, guiding them unto every good work. For thou art a good God who lovest mankind. Unto thee do we ascribe glory, to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages. Of H.R.
Peace be unto all.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
O Lord our God, who is the copy of the servant of the patriarch Abraham into Mesopotamia when he was sent to espouse the wife of his Lord Isaac, who by means of the drawing of waters revealed to him that he should betroth Rebekah. Do thou the same, Lord, bless also the betrothal of these thy servants, Alexander and Stephanie, and confirm them the promise which they have made, establish them in the holy union which is from thee. For in the beginning thou didst make them male and female, and by thee the woman is joined unto the man as a helper, and for the procreation of the human race. Therefore, Lord our God, who has sent forth thy truth upon thine inheritance, and thy covenant to thy servants our fathers, thine elect from generation to generation, look upon thy servant Alexander and thy handmaid Stephanie, and establish and make firm their betrothal in faith and in oneness of mind, in truth and in love. For thou, O Lord, hast declared that a pledge should be given and confirmed in all things. By a ring, power was given to Joseph in Egypt. By a ring, Daniel was glorified in the land of Babylon. By a ring, the uprightness of Tamar was revealed. By a ring, our Heavenly Father showed his bounty upon his Son. For he said, bring the fatted calf and kill it, and let us eat and make merry. By thine own right hand, O Lord, thou didst arm Moses in the Red Sea. By thy true word, the heavens were established, and the foundations of the earth were made firm. And by the right hands of thy servants also shall be blessed by thy mighty word, and by thine upraised arm. Therefore, O Master, bless now this putting on of the rings with your heavenly blessing, and let thine angel go before them all the days of their life. For thou art he that blesses and sanctifies all things, and unto thee do we ascribe glory, honor, and worship to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
our God, glory to thee. Stephanie, have a good, free, unconstrained will and a firm intention to take as your husband this man whom you see here before you. Have you promised yourself to any other man?
I have not.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us
us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace. Commemorating our most holy, most pure, most blessed and glorious Lady Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God. Son, to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
O God, most pure fashioner of every creature, who didst transform the rib of our forefather Adam into a wife because of thy love towards mankind, it is bless them and say to them, be fruitful and multiply, fill the earth, subdue it. Who is made of the two one flesh. Therefore a man leaves his father and his mother and cleaves to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. And what God has joined together, let no man put asunder. Thou hast blessed thy servant Abraham, opening the womb of Sarah, and hast made him to be the father of many nations. Thou hast given Isaac to Rebekah, and hast blessed her in childbearing. Thou hast joined Jacob unto Rachel, and from them hast bring forth the 12 patriarchs. Thou didst unite Joseph and Aseneth, giving unto them Ephraim and Manasseh as the fruit of their procreation. Thou didst accept Zechariah and Elizabeth, and to make their offspring to be the forerunner. From the root of Jesse, according to the flesh, thou didst bud forth the ever-virgin one, and was incarnate of her, and was born of her for the redemption of the human race. Through thine unutterable gift and manifold goodness, thou didst come to Cana of Galilee, and didst bless the marriage there, to make manifest it is thy will that there should be lawful marriage and procreation. Do thou, the same, O Holy Master, accept the prayer of us servants. As thou wast present there, be thou also present here with thine invisible protection. Bless this marriage, and grant that these thy servants, Alexander and Stephanie, a peaceful life, length of days, chastity, mutual love, and the bond of peace, long live offspring, gratitude from their children, a crown of glory that does not fade away. Graciously grant that they may see their children's children. Preserve their bed unassailed, and give them of the dew of heaven from on high, and of the fatness of the earth. Fill their houses with wheat, wine and oil, with every good thing, so that they may give in turn to those in need. And grant also to those here present and with them all those petitions which are for their salvation. For thou art the God of mercies and of bounties and of love towards mankind, and unto thee do we ascribe glory, to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Server of immortality and provider of the good things of life. The same master who in the beginning didst make man and establish him as king over creation, and didst say, it is not good that man should be alone upon the earth. Let us make a helper for him. Taking one of his ribs, thou hast fashioned woman, and when Adam saw her, he said, this is at last bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman because she was taken out of man. For this reason a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. What therefore God has joined together, let no man put asunder. Do thou now also, Master, our Lord and God, send down now thy heavenly grace upon these thy servants, Alexander and Stephanie, and grant that this thy handmaid may be subject to her husband in all things, and that this thy servant may be the head of his wife, so that they may live according to thy will. Bless them, O Lord our God, as thou hast blessed Abraham and Sarah. Bless them, O Lord our God, as thou hast blessed Isaac and Rebekah. Bless them, O Lord our God, as thou hast blessed Jacob and all the patriarchs. Bless them, O Lord our God, as thou hast blessed Joseph and Aseneth. Bless them, O Lord our God, as thou hast blessed Moses and Zipporah. Bless them, O Lord our God, as thou hast blessed Joachim and Anna. Bless them, O Lord our God, as thou hast blessed Zechariah and Elizabeth. Preserve them, O Lord our God, as thou hast preserved Noah in the ark. Preserve them, O Lord our God, as thou hast preserved Jonah in the belly of the whale. Preserve them, O Lord our God, as thou hast preserved the three holy children from the fire, sending down upon them dew from heaven. And let that gladness come upon them which the blessed Helen had when she found the precious cross. Remember them, O Lord our God, as thou hast remembered Enoch, Shem, and Elijah. Remember them, O Lord our God, as thou hast remembered thy 40 holy martyrs, sending down upon them crowns from heaven. Remember them, O Lord our God, and the parents who have nurtured them, for the prayers of parents make firm the foundations of houses. Remember, O Lord our God, thy servants, the groomsmen and the bridesmaid of the bridal pair. Bridesmaids of the bridal pair have come together in this joy. Remember, O Lord our God, thy servant Alexander and thy handmaiden Stephanie, and bless them. Grant them of the fruit of their bodies, spare children, concord of soul and body. Exalt them like the cedars of Lebanon, like a luxuriant vine. Give them offspring in number like unto full ears of grain, so that having enough of all things, they may abide in every work that is good and acceptable unto thee. Let them see their children's children like olive shoots around their table, so that finding favor in thy sight, they may shine like the stars of heaven. In thee, our God, for unto the earth all glory, honor, and worship, the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Let us pray to the Lord. Fashioned woman from his rib, and destroyed her unto him as a helper. For it seemed good to thy majesty that man should not be alone upon the earth. Do thou the same, Lord, stretch out now thy hand from this thy holy dwelling place, and delight this thy servant Alexander to this thy handmaiden Stephanie. For by thee the husband is joined to the wife. Delight them in one mind, wed them into one flesh, granting them fruit of the body for the procreation of their children. For thou art that thine is the majesty, thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Servant of God, Alexander, is crowned under the handmaiden of God, Stephen, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The servant of God, Alexander, is crowned under the handmaiden of God, Stephen, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The servant of God, Alexander, is crowned under the handmaiden of God, Stephen, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The handmaiden of God, Stephen, is crowned under the servant of God, Alexander, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The handmaiden of God, Stephanie, is crowned with the servant of God, Alexander, being the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The handmaiden of God, Stephanie, is crowned with the servant of God, Alexander, being the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us attend. Peace be unto all.
And to your spirit.
Wisdom.
The prokimen on the eighth tone. Thou hast set upon their heads crowns of precious stones. They asked life of thee, and thou gavest it them.
Let us attend.
everything in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, to God the Father. Be subject to one another out of reverence for Christ. Wives, be subject to your husbands as to the Lord, for the husband is the head of the wife, as Christ is the head of the church, his body, and his, himself is Savior. As the church is subject to Christ, so let wives also be subject in everything to their husbands. Husbands, love your wives, as Christ loved the church and gave himself up for her, that we might sanctify her, having cleansed her by the washing of water with the word, that the church might be presented before him in splendor, without spot or wrinkle or any such thing, that she might be holy and without blemish.
Yes, fiancé.
Even so, husbands should love their wives as their own bodies. He who loves his wife loves himself. For no man ever hated his own flesh, but nourishes and cherishes it, as Christ does the church, because we are members of his body. For this reason, a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one. This is a great mystery, and I take it to mean Christ and the church. However, let each one of you love your own wife as himself, and let the wife see that she respects her husband. And to your spirit, alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Thou, O Lord, shall protect us and preserve us from this generation forever.
Say with all our soul, with all our mind, let us say. O Lord Almighty, the God of our fathers, we pray thee, hearken and have mercy. Have mercy upon us, O God, according to thy great goodness, we pray thee, hearken and have mercy. Again, we pray for mercy, life, peace, health, salvation, visitation for the servants of God, Alexander and Stephanie, and for the pardon and remission of their sins.
Lord, have mercy.
Thou art a merciful God, who lovest mankind. Unto thee do we ascribe glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
O Lord, our God, who in thy saving dispensation did vouchsafe by thy presence in Cana of Galilee to declare marriage honorable, do thou the same, Lord, now maintain the peace and comfort thy servants Alexander and Stephanie, whom thou hast been pleased to join together, cause their marriage to be honorable, preserve their pretend blameless, mercifully grant that they may live together in purity, and enable them to reach a ripe old age, walking in thy commandments with a pure heart. For thou art our God, the God of mercy and of salvation. Unto thee we send up glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
And though they may be perfect, holy, peaceful, and sinless, let us ask of the Lord. A guardian of our souls and bodies, let us ask of the Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
In the remission of our sins and transgressions, let us ask of the Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
All things that are good and profitable for our souls and peace of the world, let us ask of the Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
That we may complete the remaining time of our life in peace and repentance, let us ask of the Lord. And peaceful, and a good defense before the dread judgment seat of Christ, let us ask.
And
we ask for the unity of the faith and the communion of the Holy Spirit, let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God. And make us worthy, O Master, that with boldness and without condemnation we may dare to call upon thee, the heavenly God, as Father.
Thank you.
bow your head unto the Lord. Let us pray to the Lord. O God, who has created all things by thy might, and has made the world, and adornest the crown of all that thou hast made, bless now with thy spiritual blessing this common cup, which thou didst give to those who are now united for the community of marriage. For blessed is thy name, and glorified is thy kingdom, of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Exalted like Abraham, O bridegroom, and be blessed like Isaac, and multiply like Jacob, walking in peace and keeping God's commandments and righteousness. And you, O bride, be exalted like Sarah, and exult like Rebecca, and multiply like Rachel, and rejoice in your husband, fulfilling the conditions of the law, for this is well pleasing.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
O God, our God, who didst come to Cana of Galilee and didst bless there the marriage feast, bless also these thy servants who through thy good providence now are united in wedlock. Bless their goings out and their comings in. Fill their life with good things. Receive their crowns into thy kingdom, preserving them spotless, blameless, and without reproach, unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Peace be unto all.
And unto your spirit.
Bow your heads unto the Lord.
To thee, O Lord.
May the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, in all holy, consubstantial, life-created Trinity, one God, heaven, one kingdom, bless you and grant you length of days, bear children, progress in life and faith, and fill you with all earthly good things, and make you worthy to enjoy the good things of the promise, through the prayers of the Holy Theotokos and of all the saints.
Amen.
Wisdom, most holy Theotokos, save
Glory to Jesus Christ.
Glory.
Alexander Stephanie, congratulations. You know, you have a mom, you have our whole family. You know, we're praying for you. You know, we love you. And just be faithful. I mean, your whole life was brought up here in the church. You grew up here. You did everything here within the life of the church. Just continue that. You know, expand it. Do more. Do whatever you can to bring yourself closer and closer to Christ. You know, we talk about the marriage service being a mystery. It doesn't mean that it is magical. By no means is it magical. We have to really work. You two have to really work at your marriage. And I just want to share with you a little, this is by Father Anthony Conieres. I didn't write this, but I think it's appropriate and good. He says the following: an exhaustive study of public records shows that no woman ever shot her husband while he was doing the dishes. Learn to serve each other in humility and love. He says, cultivate humility. And it really has to be cultivated. Love does not insist on its own way, as the scriptures tell us. No one except God is right all the time. Learn to apologize and to place each other first. He says, resist the impulse to give up when things get tough. He says, persevere. Studies have shown that the best marriages for most people are the ones they were in. It could be saved if they wanted it and had worked harder at it. Very important. Tell each other at least once a day, I love you. And I would suggest morning and night. When you get up, when you go to bed, you express your love for each other. Learn to surprise each other with spontaneous expressions of love. This is never let the sun go down on your anger. Talk about your differences. Forgive each other and forget before the day ends. And we had a matushka in this deanery, and she and her husband apparently had an argument, and the husband went out and he died in an auto crash. She was so, every married couple that she saw, she told them, make sure that you ask forgiveness of each other. Don't let that go by. Never yell at each other unless there's a fire in the house. It says use, you know, sort of a soft response. Treat each other as king or queen. You are crowned as such by God in this service. If he sees you as such, can you fail to see and treat each other as anything else than as the king and queen of your family? And your crowns are not just for today, but for every day of your life and to be brought into the kingdom. That's why on the eighth day, in the traditional Orthodox fashion, those crowns weren't taken off until 8 days later, after the wedding, in remembrance of that eternal nature of marriage. Never place anyone except God before your spouse. He or she comes first. Everyone and everything else comes second, third, and fourth. Your aim is not to be pleased, but to please your beloved, to give yourself to your chosen one as Christ gave himself for the church. Finally, he says, blend all these ingredients into a beautiful whole through the mixture of prayer. And as our Lord blesses and blesses your marriage, allow him to continue to do so by having him as the guest in your thoughts, deeds, and actions. Be active in your church. Live your faith. Grow in love that is both human and divine. And that's sort of the glory of our Orthodox way of life, is that it's not just the two of you, but you have all these witnesses, which is your family in Christ. You have the saints surrounding us. On this day, we have the proto-martyr of women, St. Thecla, which, say your prayers to her, icon's right over there, the first one. The cross. And Alexander today is also the first proto-martyr of America, so St. Juvenal. So remember the saints. Ask for their intercessions, especially for the Mother of God and St. John the Baptist. And if you do that, you'll stay along this line of the church, you'll stay together, you'll stay close to Christ. So congratulations again, God bless you.
In the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Alexander accepted. Congratulations. I remember Alexander probably been here for his baptism all those years ago. And it's a joy to be here at this wedding. When we read the epistle in the gospel today, it's not a sign of tyranny of the husband, as some people say. If you listen to those words carefully, what he said was, husbands, love your wife as Christ loved the church. Wives, be obedient to your husband as to Christ. What did Christ do for the church? He gave up his life. Defended it, he exalted it, he purified it, he made it a vessel of sanctification for the entire world. This is the real mystery of marriage. It's not only a crown so that you are king and queen of your own house, but it's also a crown for God, bearing witness to God. Not necessarily being put to death, but willing to do so if necessary. But bear witness to Christ in your words, your thoughts, your deeds, your relationships with other people, so that they may see the life that is within you and glorify our God. Glory to Jesus Christ.
Glory to God.
Story. I met your mother, I met your father, married them, baptized them. So, what a beautiful bride. And then only in our faith, it's a beauty for the Savior world. And you're surrounding. Could you imagine, you know, getting married somewhere else other than the church? Could you imagine? Saints looking down upon us, remembering the martyrs, and we remember the martyrs today. And simple advice, don't let the sun go down on your heart. You won't be fortunate like being married 65 years and never had an argument either. But we made up. You know, we made up in front of the children. Never. Children had to come down. Each time they came down, they had a smile on and say good morning. When they went to school, they came down dressed. We all had. Sometimes they would agitate their mother. And Matushka, the mother would go. Somebody rang the doorbell, and they would go. Six children say, all right, mommy, smile when you open the door. But never, ever let that happen to us. We ask forgiveness. And our children, the same thing. They had to kiss each other after they had to respect. They had to come and share with us. Just never let that happen. Be faithful in every place. And God bless you. His light shine on you. Very poor in the 11th child, and I thought we were millionaires because my father always said each child is worth $1 million. He came from Austria-Hungary, so he said $1 million, but tied after a dollar meant the center. And my most impressive thing today, that everything is so impressive that you have. Went around rejoice, O Isaiah, and you had the second American was going with you. How everybody's here, your whole little family that you know now. And you have these friends all your life. And you respect each other, pray for each other. And just one thing I'm going to mention. I used to bless homes. You know how I bless homes. I used to bless homes. Hospitality, it would be 11 o'clock at night, and I would say, Matushka, I said, Matushka, we're going to go. Bless the home. The Stransky, she says, you can't go at 11 o'clock at night. You boys remember, I'd go there at 11 o'clock at night, sit down, and we would eat till past midnight. And I was, well, other people slammed the door and said, would you come in? And we had our best time sitting in your home because of your parents' hospitality. So be hospitable. God bless you, keep you, and may He give you peace and love forever. Amen.
Glory to Jesus Christ.
Glory.
The last word has to be the shortest. See, I got it wrong. They both said, don't ever let the sun go down your anger. And I said, if it's 4 a.m. and you're still arguing, it's time to go to bed. So, well, listen to me. You know, coming to a beautiful church like this, surrounded by the saints, surrounded by images of Christ, the Mother of God, someone who's never been in a church like this might ask, why? The reason is because Christ does not ask us to worship the invisible God without giving us something to see, something to touch, something to smell, something to taste, something to hear. And that's also true in the community of marriage. As it says in the program, the quote from the Elder Emilio Nos, when you see your spouse, see Christ. When you hear their footsteps or see their shadow, think of Christ coming. When we went together as you took your first steps around the table, it was not a priest that led you, but the hand of Christ that seized you and led you, redeemed you, purified you, blessed you. And that simple movement around the table. God does not answer us to worship someone theoretically, someone invisible. He reveals himself to us. And in Christ, he came in a way that we could see, that we could hear, that we could touch. And now in marriage, he gives you another person so that by loving them, you would love Christ. And by coming closer to him, you would come closer to him. Everyone in our parish. Another little church created in this community. And we wish you many, many blessed, happy, healthy, joyful. Grant, O Lord, a prosperous and peaceful life, health, salvation, patience, prudence, and all good things. To Alexander II, you united in the community of marriage. John and Theodore, their sponsors, to Camilla, Mark, Ken, Tina, Sean, Nicholas, and Michael, to Juan, Susanna, Jack, and Rachel, the Archpriest Shaw, the Archpriest Haley, the Archpriest Joseph, to all the parishioners of this holy temple, to all of their family members and friends, and preserve them, O Lord, for many. Alexander and Stephanie outside. Glory to Jesus Christ.
Glory.
Now we have the parents of our groom,
Where is he? I need my dad. Where is he? To escort his beautiful daughter to go to the dance floor. Give it up for the father of the bride, everybody.
gets. First shot here. Oh, she tasted it first. Wow. All right, group gets last licks.